And most importantly, that the data at every level is publicly free, and so, and it's also potentially constitute our capability of doing these things in a real-time fashion, right? So as tweets are coming out, and I believe that transportation agencies should, in theory, be able to provide those ridership data and flow data. Now, the subway data is only very unique, right, for New York City. So if we look at Atlanta, perhaps we should look at the traffic flow data, right, the loop detector data, as opposed to subway data. So this is just one example. And also, this is, I believe this is also the first study that tried to look at the mass level reactions in the real disaster context, as opposed to individual and household reactions. And so, so as I said, I want to acknowledge, for example, NSF, who provided with, us with the money, and my student who did all the work, and there were a lot of calculations. So, on our supercomputer at UW, and Dan Warwick, who's a collaborator, who also, he provided the taxi data as well as many critical comments. So thank you very much. I think I'm only like 1 minute over.
Questions or comments?
Very interesting study. In the study, the results that you show the changes day by day. Did you look at hourly changes, for example? Because
yeah,
the data have that.
That's a very good question. Yes. No, we wouldn't be able to look at the hourly, but we were thinking about looking half day, okay? And because of the limit of the sample size, right? And so altogether for social media Twitter data, there were only about 174,000 tweets, okay? And so we were thinking, I think the Twitter data will allow us, the size of the Twitter data will allow us to look at half day time frames. But we didn't do that because the data we got from the subway is on a daily basis. So we didn't actually want to go back to the, I mean we could, but you know, I don't think it changes greatly about the results. And so we didn't, I mean, so you could potentially, I don't think by hour, you know, that's in theory is more desirable, but you probably don't have it for the Twitter data sample size. Yeah. That's a very good question.
Kelly? The use of social media, in a lot of cases, we worry about any sort of bias that's introduced because this is not sort of representative of the population as a whole. What sort of impact do you see that having here? I mean, you would still see the, you know, that people are aware of it, but if you were trying to measure like magnitude of awareness or something like that, maybe this is not quite representative of New York City.
Right, so that's also a very good question. Yes, I mean, it could potentially have this representativeness problem. For this particular study, I think it's probably not that significant because we are comparing before and then after. Mm-hmm. See what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And we are also, right. And so we're not really right. And so, but you're right that even with cell phone data, I'm going to attack Bill King again, I think it's not representative, even though he might claim it's representative. So, for social media Twitter data, it's definitely not representative. It's less of a problem here, we think, because we are comparing the pre-disaster, so we're taking this life cycle perspective.
So my question is just clarifying. So in terms of the social media data, you explain the interaction between different nodes. So this kind of, you know, behavioral sense, people may interact with the people they didn't interact with before,
mm-hmm.
like right after the Sandy. But in terms of the taxi data and the New York City transit data, I was not sure what that deviation is. I mean, behavior. So did they travel to a different location compared to?
So we didn't answer those questions, and some of the other papers answered. So for example, that people have found travel distance have become larger. And people have found that after disaster, for example, the Haiti earthquake, people found that the pattern, human mobility pattern, became actually more regular. You can predict even better after the disaster. I mean, that's all fairly predictive, but that was not our interest for this particular study. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, like what actually they did. Did they go to a more faraway place? And we were more just interested in the timing. Can we do it? Can we detect it? It actually has both, but we only use the we only use the pickups just to be consistent with the subway data. It actually has both, so we could have done, that, but the project is finishing. I need to move to something else. The harsh reality. But yeah, but if you are interested.
That note, I think we shall conclude and thank Cynthia once again for